Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Hey viewers, may peace be upon you. Hope you all are doing well. In this video, we are going to discuss the units of some physical quantities. We will also talk about the conversion of units. Let's get started. The first topic in this video is units. The word unit in the physics, it is referred to magnitude of a quantity, that magnitude is always defined by law. Unit is also used as a standard for measurement. For the same kind of physical quantities, any other quantity is the multiple of that unit. If we are measuring the same physical quantity in different units, that another unit will be the multiple of the basic physical unit. Now, I'm giving you an example of, for example, length is a physical quantity. Whose unit is meter. Since meter is the unit of the physical quantity, that is length, therefore meter also got the following characteristics. Meter is a magnitude. How? It is defined by law, that is 1 meter is the distance traveled by light in 1/299792458 times of a second. It means if we divide a second with this big value, then in that time the distance traveled by light will be the 1 meter. Laboratories around the world are set up to check that measuring device match this standard or not. The 3 points have been covered in this definition, but the last one, that it's a multiple, we can say we have another unit of length, that is centimeter. We have one more unit of length, that is kilometer. We also know millimeter. All these units have some additional values, that are milli, kilo and centi. These are not units. Unit in each case is meter. These are called as prefixes, which are a number that is multiplying with it, which you can call it the multiple. Now, moving on towards the real definition of unit. From the above examples, we can reach to the conclusion that units are standard for measurements. Of a physical quantity that needs clear definition to be useful. One thing is necessary, that the definition is clear. It is clear to everyone in the whole world, and it is obvious in the whole world. Like the speed of light is constant throughout the world, so it is easily checked throughout the laboratories that their unit of meter is accurate or not. Now we are going to talk about prefixes. The prefix is a word that we often use in English language about those words that we use. Pre means before any letter or word. Prefix, we usually fix it before units. And these prefixes sometimes increase the value of the unit, or sometimes decrease the value of the unit according to their values, because they are multiplying with the standard of that unit. As you know, the unit of length is meter, but you might also have seen the unit of length named as centimeter or kilometer. This centi is a number. It represents a number that is the centi means 100 parts or 1/100 times of something. So centimeter means a meter which is divided by 100, or we have divided a meter into 100 parts, is its single part will be 1 centimeter. Now we are going to discuss some common prefixes and their symbols. As you know, these prefixes are written in shorthand method as a single letter, as a single small letter, sometimes a capital letter is also used. Now I am going to draw a table in which prefix its symbol and its value is going to be discussed. First prefix that we are going to discuss is deci. Its symbol is D. Its value is 1 upon 10 or 0.1 of something or in 10 to the power minus 1. This is scientific form. We also use it in many cases. Next is centi. Centi symbol is C and its numerical value is 1 upon 100 or 0.01 or 10 less to the power minus 2. The next symbol, the next prefix is milli. Milli symbol is M. Its value is 1 upon 1000 or 0.001 or 10 less to the power minus 3. The next prefix is micro. Its symbol is mu. Its value is 1 upon 1 million or 0.501 and or 10 less to the power minus 6. As the values are big, scientific form is more feasible or reliable to use. Next is nano. Nano symbol is N. Its value is 10 less to the power minus 9. Next is prefix that enlarges the value of any unit, that is kilo. Kilo's symbol is K. Its value is 1000 or 10 less to the power 3. The next, that is mega. Unit that we use is capital M and its value is 1 million or 10 less to the power 6. Now we are going to discuss the units of some basic physical quantities like length, volume, mass, density, and time. Starting from length. As we have discussed earlier in this video, that length's basic or SI unit is meter. But we know its other units as well, like centimeter, kilometer, millimeter, micrometer, and so on. All these are the multiples of the basic unit, that is meter. The unit, similarly, the unit that we use for volume, its SI unit is, since in volume we multiply three sides of a shape that has the same unit meter. So the SI unit for volume is meter की पावर मीटर एक्स मीटर क्यूब. बट देयर आर अदर यूनिट्स लाइक सेंटीमीटर क्यूब, मिलीमीटर क्यूब, लीटर, मिलीलीटर, वन थिंग दैट इज नोटिसेबल दैट लीटर इज ऑल्सो द यूनिट इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू द यूनिट डेसीमीटर क्यूब एंड मिलीलीटर इज इक्वल टू द यूनिट सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट मास, mass of an object is the amount of matter it is made up of. Mass represents the amount of matter something has. Mass is measured in kg. This is the SI unit, but it has some other units as well, like gram, like milligram, like pounds. But a density is something else. Density is a property of material. It tells us how concentrated its mass is. In everyday speech, we might say that lead is heavier than wood. We means that given equal volumes of lead and wood, the lead is heavier. If we have given the equal volume of lead and wood, the lead will be heavier. In scientific terms, we call it that the density of lead is more than the density of wood, and we define density as the mass concentrated per unit volume of something. Since it is the division of two units, mass and volume, two physical quantities, mass and volume, therefore its unit is also derived from the division of them. Like if we use the symbol for unit for mass as kg and unit for volume as meter cube, we will get the unit of density as kilogram per meter cube. Similarly, I am going to draw a table in which unit of mass, unit of volume, and its corresponding unit of density. Is going to be discussed. If the unit of mass is kilogram and the unit of volume is meter cube, the unit of density will be kilogram per meter cube. If the unit of mass is kilogram and unit of volume is liter, then answer will be kilogram per liter. If the unit of mass is gram and the volume is centimeter cube, the answer will be gram per centimeter cube. The next topic that we will discuss is time. The SI units of time is second. And usually we use three different units to measure time, that is second, minute, and hours. But we have other units of time that goes in noticeable from us. For example, a day is also a unit of time. Month, week, year, they all are the units of time. Now we are going to form some relations between these different units of time. First of all, 1 minute means 60 seconds. 1 hour means 60 minutes, and it also means 3600 seconds. 1 day means 24 hours, which means 24 is multiplied by 3600, which is the value 86,400. If we talk about 1 week, as you know, it contains 7 days. So we will multiply the seconds of 1 day with 7 day. So we will get the answer. Similarly, if you want to find out the seconds in 1 year, as we know, there are 365 days in a year, but there is a leap year in which we have one extra day. So we divide 1 by 4 and add it into this quantity, so it becomes 365.25. days on an average. And when we multiply it with the quantity that is for 1 day, we get this big value. Now moving on to the most awaited topic of this unit, that is unit conversion. I have written and the prefixes and their values at this over here, so that I can use in the examples that I'm going to discuss with you. The first example is to convert 280 centimeter into meter. The step is simple. First, write the value that is given with its unit, that is 280 centimeter. Then make a column like this. Draw a row, horizontal row, and make columns as you need. You can increase the number of columns. Now use the prefix. We need an identity to solve conversion. We need a relationship that is between centimeter and meter. And I know from prefixes that 1 centimeter. Centi means 1 centi means 1 centi means 1 upon 100 or 0.01 or 10 less to the power minus 2. I can use any one of these values. I am using the middle value, that is 0.01. So I am saying that 1 centi means 0.01 and meter is written as it is. It means 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01 meter, and I am using this relation in the above example as 280 centimeter. I have to write these two values in the vertical column, but the key point is I will write it as so that centimeter is cancelled with this centimeter, like 1 centimeter and 0.01 meter. Since this is denominator and this is numerator, so centimeter can be cancelled from the centimeter, and by simply multiplying these values and dividing with this value, I will get my answer, that is 2.8, and now the unit of this value is 2.8 meters. This is the technique that we will continue in other examples. For example, question number 2 is 3.7 kilometer into meters. Now, how to convert? We will use the same pattern, that writing it and making a column like this, and I have to find out the relation between kilometers and meters. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1k means 1000. So 1 kilometer means 1000 meter. Now using it in a way that kilometer is cancelled with kilometer, so 1 kilometer is written below and the value that it is equals to will be written over here. So kilometer is cancelled with kilometers, and the answer we obtain is 3700 meters. Next, liters into milliliters. As you know, milli means 10 to the power minus 3 or 1 upon 1000. I will use it directly as 0.75 liters, and to cancel liter, I want ml to write here, like 1 ml means 1 milli means 10 less to the power minus 3 and liters. So liter is cancelled from liter, and the answer we obtain is by using scientific calculator or any other instrument, we will get 0.75 multiplied by 1000, because 10 less to the power minus 3, when it goes to the upward position, it will become 10 less to the power 3, which is 1000, and When 0.75 is multiplied with 1000, the answer is 75 ml. Moving on to the next question. Question number 4, that is 2.3 kg into gram. It is simple. It is same as we have done in the meters. Because the base unit is gram, we do not change it, but we are going to change the kilo. Now, as we know, 1 kg means 1000 grams, then kg is cancelled with kg, 2.3 is multiplied with 1000, and we will get 2300 grams. Now question number 5, 150 kilogram per meter cube, that is the unit of density. Change it into gram per centimeter cube. Now this is the example that I was telling you about, in which we have to make multiple number of columns. Like we have 150 kilograms and in its division there is meter cube. We have to convert kilogram into grams and meter cube into centimeter cube. So first, converting kilogram into gram, 1 kg equals to 1000 grams. So kilogram is cancelled with kilogram and the new unit of mass is gram now. Next, converting meter cube into centimeter cube. As we know that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 to the power minus 2 meter. We want the unit in cube, so we will take cube root on both sides, and 1 centimeter cube will be equal to 10 to the power minus 6 minus 6 meter cube. So putting these two values so that meter cube is cancelled, we will put it like that: 1 centimeter cube is equals to 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube, so that meter cube is cancelled with meter cube, and the answer we obtain will be 0.15 gram per centimeter cube. Next example is 5000 millimeter into kilometers. Cannot be directly converted into kilometers. First we have to convert it into meters, and then we will do it to the kilometers, but we will do it at the same time. How? Let me show you. 5000 millimeters one millimeter is equals to 10 to the power minus 3 meter by using prefixes. And now I need it to be kilometers, so 1 kilometer means 10 to the power 3 meters. So millimeter is cancelled with millimeter and meter is cancelled with meter. By solving it with scientific calculator, we will get the answer as 0.05005 kilometers. Now, another case in which we do not have to use prefix, but the relations that are determined are used in it, like 120 pounds in 2 kilograms. As you know, it's a common practice that 1 kg is equal to 2.205 pounds. We will use this relation directly as 120 pounds, and we will use kg here and pounds value here, so that pound is cancelled with pound and our answer is in kg. So 120 is divided by 2.205, so that we can have our answer, that is 54.421 kg. Discussing the last example, that is again a complicated one, that is 3.5 hours into microsecond. Again, this question is similar as we have done question number 6. First, we have to apply the conversion from hours to second, and then we will move from second to microsecond. How? As we know, 3.5 hours, 1 hour means 3600 seconds. First, we use this relation, and then we will move from seconds to microsecond. And as we know, 1 micro means 10 less to the power minus 6 second. So after solution of this 3.5 into 30, you notice that hour is cancelled with hour and second is cancelled with second, and the only unit that is left is microsecond. Now solving this relation, we will get the value, that is 1.26 10 less to the power 10 microseconds. If you have any question, then write down in the comments. I have also added some practice questions for you in the description.